Hello, this recording is to document the process of two new tools for signing and sealing BIM files or electronic delivery files, CAD files, etc. With the July release of the FDOTConnect CADD software, two new tools were introduced into the desktop folder for signing and sealing CAD files. One is the BIM Cryptor and the other is the BIM Validator, these two tools right here. Now, the end result is that you will end up with a manifest that is printed or that is shown on the signature page. And then your digital signature is applied along on it, along with the standard roadway plans and the digital signature notes. So I want to show you the process. So when you're ready to start creating the manifest to be put on the signature page, what you'll do is go to the BIM Cryptor tool. And it brings up a dialog that allows you to browse to the project folder. So over here on my machine in the worksets folder, I have a project here. And all you have to do is go to the project path and choose OK. And it's going to go out and look and find all of the DGNs, DWGs, XML files, if there's iModels, it will also include those that are in the file. It skips any text file or spreadsheet files, but it basically includes anything that could be a digital delivery type file in each of the folders. From there, you simply will check the files that you want included in the manifest that are going to be considered signed and sealed CAD files in your contract deliverables. So I'm going to select the earthwork files, the XMLs that created the earthwork for existing, proposed, and subgrade. I'm also going to get the alignment files. And then if there's a model file that goes with it, you can select that. You can also go out and get, if there's a drainage file that's going to be delivered and signed and sealed, or a pond that has earthwork information in it. Any other files that you want to include, maybe the model, the master model. And then from there, you're going to choose this generate hash. It'll go out and it'll create a spreadsheet called contract BIM files in your meta info folder of your project, or you can redirect it if you need to. So I'm going to overwrite this file here. And then it will open up the file. And what it does is it goes out and it generates a 256 encryption code for each of the files. So that then therefore makes this file unique in its content at this date and time. So if anything were to change in this file, then this encryption code would no longer be valid. And so this encryption code will essentially secure it for anything that's been changed. The other thing that it does is it actually goes out and it sets the properties on all these files to read-only. So if I were to come out here to this folder, this project folder, and look in the 3D deliverables for one of these files that I just put a hash on, you'll see that the read-only has been set for that and each and every other one. If I look at any of these, you'll see they've all been set to read-only. So once that file is created, you can go ahead and choose save. The other two things before I choose save and get out is that this file description comes from the file properties. if you want to overwrite this and be more specific, call this for 2D line work or 2D planimetrics or whatever you want to call it for 2D lines, and then find the one for 3D lines and say for 3D lines. And you can make edits to this spreadsheet, but you shouldn't change any of the formatting of the columns or the borders, any of that information, because this is set up to work with the LDM tool directly. Now, the other thing about this is this 256 hash code or encryption code can be found in multiple sources. If you just did a Google for generating a 256 hash on any file, it doesn't matter what format it is. It could be a spreadsheet, it could be a folder, it could be a picture. All you'd have to do is essentially drag the file onto, like in this case, this is a GitHub link that we provided in the spreadsheet so you could verify this. Of course, this is for 256 encryption. Notice all the different encryption formats there are. So we're just happen to pick the 256 encryption, and if I drag this file onto here, you'll see it's going to generate a hash code. And there is the encryption code. And if I were to copy this and go over to the spreadsheet for that particular file, so that was the US98 XML file. That's this one here. And let's say I insert a column. I could come over here and check this, and those numbers should match. And in fact, they do. It's just one's in uppercase and the other one's in lowercase. So this one for CADD is putting everything in uppercase, but it still is a valid encryption code. All right, so I'll Control Z and get rid of that column, but I did just verify. Another way to verify any encryption code is you can actually do it from the command line. So if you were just to bring up a Windows command line prompt and then key in this command, cert utility minus hash file, and then give it the full path name and file name, and then say the encryption code 256, it would return to you the actual encryption code for that file. But since I have this file open, which is the contract.bimfiles.xls, if I close this out and save it the way it was and rerun that, you can see it's just generated a 256 encryption code for the contract BIM files, okay, which isn't in my list because the actual XLS file is the file. But you could also create it for that one and save it for your records. Now, that's in the meta info folder of the project. Once you have it in there, then it's just a matter of going to the Link Data Manager tool, which is delivered with FDOTConnect under the FDOT tab. There's Link Data Manager. And then you just create a new link and you browse out to that location. Select the file, choose open. And then, of course, you always have to pick the sheet where the table exists. And then you would just choose OK. And wait for it to essentially process all the graphics, and eventually it'll come up on your cursor. And so there is the new version of it. This was an older version of it that I had out there, but essentially that's how you would place it. From there, you would go ahead and add in your appearance of your seal, add your digital signature, you know, the other notes that need to be on the signature page, print it to PDF, and now you've essentially signed and sealed the manifest of all of the CAD files or electronic delivery files or digital delivery files that you're delivering as contract documents with the project. And that's as simple as it is. Now, another tool that we delivered is the BIM Validator tool. And this does just the opposite. It'll go out and it'll see if any of the files have changed. So let's just run it on that file, on that spreadsheet, which it's closed. So let me make sure I go over here and find the work set and go to the project that has the meta info folder with the contract files. If I choose open, it's going to go through and find everything that was in the list, and of course I duplicated that one and saved it, so that file doesn't exist, and show it, so it shows failed. So I would have to go into the spreadsheet and make sure I deleted that entry that I had placed in there. But let me go ahead and open one of these other files, and I'll just add a line, and you'll see that it will not pass the encryption once a file has been edited. So again, I'll go out to where these files are located, and I'll just open up this earthwork file with a, well, first I'll need to change the properties of it so that I can write to it. And then I'll go in and just make a simple edit by deleting this row here, this blank row in row two. I'll just delete that and then save it. So I didn't change any content, but I did, you know, delete one row so that the file has changed. Now if I close out of here and run the BIM validator, I should get another error at that file location. So again, I'll go to the workset, FDOT, the project meta info folder, select that, choose OK. Now it's going out and looking what's in that XLS file, and then it finds the location of the file and it will return to me whether or not that encryption code is still valid. So something changed with this file, which we know, and it tells me the note is that the encryption hash does not match. So you know, that file is no longer valid. Now the other thing that you can do is obviously save this to a report, and it saves it to the meta info folder here as well. And with that, that covers the two new tools that are delivered in the workspace and how they're utilized.